uncertainty principle is one of the most popular concepts of the quantum mechanics. Let me introduce a misconception about the uncertainty principle. When you are to see matter, say a particle, you need a light to be scattered off. You observe the scattered light to get any information about the particle. But the particle is also scattered away, and you cannot get all the information about the particle at the same time. The uncertainty principle is sometimes explained in this way, but it is wrong. The uncertainty principle is not about our limits of technique or observation. The uncertainty principle is about wave nature of matter. What is a wave? Before we get into the matter wave, what is a wave? A wave is a collective oscillation of a medium or anything. A key concept of a wave is that the collective oscillation propagates its oscillation to the neighborhoods. For example, water wave needs medium, but a light wave doesn't. A wave can propagate behind an obstacle. It is called diffraction. Let us imagine the edge of a plane wave. Imagine that the medium at the edge of the plane wave oscillates, while the medium right next to it doesn't. Then, it does not make sense of a wave. The medium right next to the edge must feel any force or drive from the plane wave. A wave can interfere. When two waves of the same kind meet together, they pass through each other. If we take a closer look at what is happening when they overlap, we see the interference of waves. Waves can superpose and can be decomposed into each individual wave. Interference or superposition is a property of a wave, not a particle. When two particles meet together, they collide. Matter is a wave. Light is matter. At the same time, light is an electromagnetic wave. How do we know that light is a wave? Light has properties of a wave. The first experimental proof to show that light is a wave is a double slit experiment. The double slit experiment showed light can diffract and interfere at the same time. How about matter other than light? Like an atom. An atom consists of electrons and a nucleus. A nucleus consists of protons and neutrons. They do collide like a particle, but only in a good approximation. Matter can be accurately described as a wave, a matter wave. A matter wave does not need a medium. A matter wave propagates and spreads out in space. We can interpret the matter wave as a probability density spread out in space. Is there any experimental results to show that matter other than light is a wave? Yes, there have been numerous reports and experiments that prove or use the wave nature of matter. A famous example is again the double slit experiment. The setup consists of a source that shoots matter waves, a single slit, a double slit, and a detector. Slits block all the matter waves except for small gaps. The single slit defines the phase of the wave and generates a spatially coherent wave. Some portion of the matter wave reaches the double slit, and again, two spatially coherent waves are generated. We count how many matter waves have reached the detector one by one. It turned out that the counts as a function of the position of the detector is exactly the same as the interference pattern of waves. Can we count the matter wave? Matter behaves like a particle whenever we detect it. It is called wavefunction collapse and deeply related to the quantum decoherence, interaction of matter wave and everything else. That's the topic for another video. Matter propagates, diffracts, and interferes. Matter is a wave. Matter wave and the uncertainty principle. The uncertainty principle is a property of a wave applied to the matter wave. Here is a wave packet. Can you estimate the position of the wave? What is the accuracy of your estimation? The situation is getting worse when you are trying to estimate the position of the wave with a single frequency. We can say that the wave exists everywhere with the same amplitude at best. On the other end, here is a wave with a narrow distribution in space so that the position is well defined. Can you estimate the frequency of the wave? What is the accuracy of your estimation in this case? The wave oscillates less than one time in space. The situation is getting worse if we assume a point-like distribution of the wave in space. We can say that the wave oscillates with every frequency with the same amplitude at best. if a wave oscillates with a single frequency, then it is hard to say the position of the wave. On the other hand, if the position of the wave is narrow in space, then we cannot specify a single frequency of the wave. These are extreme cases of the uncertainty principle of a wave. If you apply this argument to the matter wave, it is the well-known Heisenberg's uncertainty principle. For example, let us consider the uncertainty principle of a matter wave in space. The narrower the spatial distribution is, the broader the momentum distribution is, and vice versa. This can be well explained by Fourier transformation or Fourier analysis. We can generalize the uncertainty principle to any two conjugate variables, for example, time and energy. To conclude, matter is a wave, and the Heisenberg's uncertainty principle is a physical example of a general property of a wave in terms of a matter wave. I try not to discuss mathematical details in this video because I want to give you an intuitive idea of the uncertainty principle. I'll upload a bit more detailed version of the uncertainty principle later on. Thanks for watching, and please leave a comment if you have any question, and I'll try to answer for you.